They didn't tell me an audience was coming, so that changes quite a bit. But anyway, thank you so much for coming to this nonsense. I am Ted L. Nancy, and I appreciate it. And I'd like to tell you a little bit about how all this started, how I got into to writing these letters and getting these responses. Kind of an interesting story. So let me just make my way out here now. Walking, dead man walking. And now I am here. True story, like I said, kind of interesting, was about 20 years ago, and I'm sitting in my room. It's about 4 o'clock in the morning, and I was sitting in my room with my lady friend Phyllis, and she was watching TV, kind of half listening to me, and I was sitting in another chair, mindlessly eating a bag of Fritos. You know how you kind of just shovel snacks in and stuff like that? I shouldn't be eating Fritos then, and I shouldn't be eating Fritos now, because I've had a weight problem my whole life, and it's I cannot lose any weight. And I think I've built myself into the body of a small pot roast, is what it is. Here's terrible dieter, constant yo-yo dieting. I just went on one diet. I had to go on two diets at the same time because one diet wasn't giving me enough food. Listen, I know I'm not a Chippendale dancer. Those days are over. More like a Chip Ahoy dancer. Easy, easy now. Terrible exerciser. I spent 2 hours at the gym this morning. I finally found parking. That gym is called Dead Man Working Out. My idea of a good workout is I like to strap myself on to another person while they're exercising. Anyway, so I'm eating these Fritos, and I noticed on the side of the bag of the Fritos, you know, they had like a little message that said, you got any problems, any issues? Write Fritos with your issues. We want to hear from you. Thinking, well, who needs to write Fritos? You know, you got issues, go to a therapist, you know? You don't want to unload on a corn chip company with your problems, you know? And Phyllis is going, uh-huh, yeah, kind of half listening. And I go, what would you say to Fritos? I'm talking out loud. I go, would you act like you're a moron and you don't understand what a Frito is? You can't understand the concept of what they're... I have no idea what you're doing here. What is this? And you explain the product. I opened your product, this Frito thing that you have, and they were all stale, and they were crunchy, and they were hard, and I got orange dust all over me, and I had to throw the whole... I had to throw the whole thing away. It was stale. And I said, who would write Fritos? And Phyllis goes, a nut. That's who would write Fritos. Then the next day, I'm in the 99-cent store buying some Bon Ami cleanser because I only like cleanser from 1920. And I see the same kind of message. It says, you got any problems, any issues? Write Bon Ami. We want to hear from you. And it's stamped Gordon Brewcar V. But I'm looking at the stamp, and it was smudgy. It could be Gordon Brewcar IV. I'm studying the stamp, you know, and maybe that's Gordon Brewcar III. And I'm building this whole fantasy of Gordon Brewcar in my head. Is there five Gordon Brewcars there selling cleanser? Is there one Gordon Brewcar? Have I stumbled on a Gordon Brewcar nest? What is going on here? What would I say to him? What would I want to write to this man? I want to get into Gordon Brewcar's life. Would I tell him my Fritos issues? What would I say to him? Then I started noticing it like calling to me, like, you know, all these companies wanted you to write to them and they wanted you to reach out and answer them. I get my gas bill, and the gas bill says, hey, you got any problems? You want to write to us? Tell us what you think of our gas pamphlets. And I go, well, you know, I collect the gas pamphlets and I'm missing the complete set from 1988. With all of your gas all-stars. So I thought, you know what? I'm going to write to these people because they want to hear from me. And why not? I've got 23 hours a day to kill.